So hi again,
hi,
Mr. Jackman.
Anyway,
glad to see you so healthy and so well and so.
Thank you. Yeah, now I'm feeling good. It's good to be here in Singapore, and thank you for coming in. And
thank you.
I'm very excited about the movie, and everything's going well. Thank you.
As Wolverine, can you mutate and regenerate whatever's wrong with yourself?
Yeah. I wish I had the Wolverine ability now. I had a minor form of skin cancer taken out the other day. I don't heal nearly as quickly as Wolverine does.
How do you get it, and what advice can you give people so they can avoid?
It's the sun damage, and mainly from when I was a kid. It was not in the culture so much to wear sunscreen back then. And as a kid growing up in Australia with English parents and English sort of blood, you know, I was very much at risk. But we didn't, nobody really knew back then. People used to be more like adamant about not going into the pool after 30 minutes of eating, right? You know, it was a very strict rule. You had to wait 30 minutes after. But I don't remember people saying you've got to put sunscreen on, you know, getting into the pool. But obviously by the time I was about 16, 17, sunscreen, people were becoming aware of it. Now I am, but I'm paying for it. So get checkups to check your skin, particularly around my age of 45, but wear sunscreen.
Oh, nice to hear that. You lost a lot of pounds for Les Miserables.
Yeah.
And you got it back. And you work out for Wolverine. Did you do the same workout for X-Men?
I kind of had more time. I realized that I need a minimum of 6 months to get into shape. And that's already if I'm training. Because it's a pretty extreme type, a body type that I was going for, muscly but extremely lean, and that just takes time. So I had 12 months before the Wolverine. Then I did another movie, and then I was straight into this. So I just kept going. You know, I was on that thing for two and a half years.
You did another exciting scene in this movie,
yeah.
Just like in Wolverine, the bathtub scene.
I guess, yeah.
How did you feel about this one? It will excite a lot of women all over the world. Did you have to do special workout for that?
Oh, yeah. I can tell you, that was May 21.
I do extra lunges.
May 21.
Lunges for the butt. And May 21 was the date we shot that because, you know, if you ask a bodybuilder, they will have a specific program they will go on to lead up to so that they peak on a particular day for the competition. And that's how I treated it. So training beforehand, your diet starts to change again about 4 weeks before. You don't drink any liquids for 36 hours before the day, and that really dries you out and makes you look even leaner and tighter. And so all of those things I was doing is just to make sure that I was in peak condition.
It's a long process. You have a Chinese mutant in X-Men.
Yes.
What about a Filipino mutant in one
of
the X-Men movies?
Yeah, I agree. I think there should be. You know, the X-Men is becoming more and more international, not only the fans, but the storylines, and that's exactly how it should be. Our world is getting more interdependent. We're all having to come together to solve different things, and I think that's very much the message of this movie, actually, that we need to come together in a spirit of tolerance and acceptance. And so I'm all for, I'm an Aussie, so yeah. Playing a Canadian. So it's, you know, there should be different characters from all around the world. Maybe you could be in it, Ricky.
Yeah.
What would your mutant power? Maybe you could be the Filipino mutant.
Ricky. Oh, you asked me the same question before.
I did. What would your power be?
In the Philippines?
Yeah.
Oh, there's so many actors that are competent enough to be in Hollywood, just like you. Anyway, you're very young. In your early 20s, no? And you've been Wolverine.
I'll be honest with you, late 20s, man.
Yes.
It's all right.
You've been a Wolverine X-Men for 14 years, and that's one third of your life. How do you see yourself 14 years from now, and how do you see the franchise 14 years from now?
I think I have no idea what I'm going to be doing 14. I don't know what I'm doing next year, man.
Really?
I have no idea. No, man, that excites me. You know, I think part of being an actor or being an artist is staying open. You have to listen to inspiration, listen to your gut about where to go. And I never thought I'd be here 14 years ago, so who knows where I'll be going from here. But the franchise itself, I think, is in better shape than ever. It feels fresh. It feels open. In a way, this movie has wiped the slate clean. I feel like we could go in any direction. Channing Tatum's just come on board playing Gambit. You know, I think it's an exciting world, and X-Men seems stronger as a franchise than ever.
Well, I presume that Wolverine, the Logan character, has become second skin to you.
Yeah.
It has. You know, it's... I hope I don't get in trouble by saying this. But I feel like it's like a second marriage in a way, because when you play someone, you have to kind of know them. You have to love them. You have to stay. Yeah, it's within you. You know what I mean? I don't go around being Wolverine at home or anything, but I know him that well, and it's something I'm very grateful for.
This is showing May 21st in Manila. Yes. Is it okay for you to invite your fans back in Manila, just like what we did?
To everyone in Manila, to everyone in the Philippines, I really hope you enjoy X-Men Days of Future Past as much as we loved making it. I'm very excited about the movie. I think it's one of the best of the lot, and I think fans and people who come to it fresh are going to love it just as much as each other. So I really hope you get to see it, and I hope to see you in the Philippines soon.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Ricky.